Last time I was on this location, I showed you a hack where you could use the return to home feature of the drone to sort of emulate course lock, where you fly it from point A to point B, and you'll be able to operate the drone independently while you're flying between these two positions. I chose to fly to the home point and then update it through the app. But many of you pointed out below the video there was a much smarter way that could be utilized, and that was to set the home point directly on the map. So this is one thing that we're going to do today. In addition, as a bonus tip, I will show you how you can use this function to do something that resembles waypoints, where you fly from one point to the next point, as we're going to update the home point dynamically while we're in the air. And today we are using an ND8 from Freewell. And if you happen to miss the video that I made about ND filters and how you can use those together with the DJI Mini 2 or the Mini 1, for that sake, I'll make sure to leave a link in the description below. Let's double check here. Just make sure that we have the right shutter speed. Put it down to the double of the frame rate. So, and then it's slightly underexposed. So right now we are running with a shutter speed that is 1/60, which is the double of the frame rate, which is all right according to the 180 degree rule. Let's launch the drone and see what we can make out of it. So right now the home position is above where the car is parked. Let's start by flying the drone out here so I can show you what options are available. So now the drone is positioned here up nicely. So let's look at our options. The first thing that you need to pay attention to is the return to home height, as this will define the height that the drone is returning. So we're going to put that at 70 meters. That's a nice safe distance above these wind turbines. The next thing that we can do is I can go in here and I can say update home point, and you get this map view. The options that you have right now is that you can either set the home point where the drone is located by pressing the triangle, or you can decide if the home point should be where the remote is located. You simply press the remote. The third option is that you can zoom out on the map here. It's a little bit fiddly to do. Then you simply drag the home point to some position here on the map where you want the drone to go. And then you simply press OK. And then it tells you the home point has been updated. So when I press return to home right now, the drone will start to go to this new home point position that I just put out. And I can decide if I want to put the camera in a completely different angle when the drone is flying, so it makes a nice video when it passes by these wind turbines. And one of the really cool things are that I can right now, I can update the home point dynamically. So I can basically go in here and I can say, okay, I just wanted to go back to where the controller is, like that, and then press okay. And what you'll see now is now the drone changes direction, and it will basically fly back. And I get the weak antenna because I'm sitting inside the car here. You see, now it flies back to where the car is located. And again, I can on the fly, while it's moving here, I can go in here and I can say update home point. I can say, okay, I don't want it to go back to the car. I want it to turn around and go to somewhere in the middle of the field. And if I do that, you can see, before it reaches the home point, it will change direction again. That's one of the annoying things, is if you change the home point dynamically, you lose the ability to change the camera angle. So in that case, we need to stop the mission shortly and then reinitiate it. So now I can change the camera position independently. So it's not really waypoints as we know them. It's pretty cool that you can dynamically change this while it's in the air. So let's just go under update home point here. In this case, we just want the drone to go back home like this, where the controller is positioned. Press OK. The home point has been updated. And again, I can't change the rotation of the drone. So what I need to do here is I need to press pause and then reinitiate it here. What you can see is that it's heading towards the home point, but the drone is pointing in a completely different direction than what we're flying. So that is a pretty, pretty cool feature. You see, it should position itself right above the car. Yes. And then it will, of course, start to land. And that is, of course, something that you need to be really careful about. When you're updating the home point for any other position than your takeoff position, when it reaches the home point, it will start to land. And of course, if you're in a critical low battery situation where it forces itself into a return to home, that might cause you some problems if you don't know if the area is suitable for landing below the drone. I hope this gave you some ideas to stuff that you can play around with. So this was a rough explanation about how you can update the home point using the map function that is made available from the DJI Fly app. And you can add some sort of waypoint functionality to the drone. Of course, it's not real waypoints that like we know from some of the bigger DJI drones or from the Mavic Mini using the Litchi app. But at least you can update the points where you're flying dynamically while you're in the air, even though you have to use the pause button and reinitiate the return to home to be able to turn the camera when it's when you are heading towards the second home point. I hope you liked this video. If you did, then feel free to give it a like. If you didn't like it, feel free to press the dislike button twice. Thank you for watching, and I'll be seeing you around.